Blender has an awesome new workflow that allows you to stylize and paint over your 3D objects in real time. You don't need any add-ons, complex node groups, or external programs for this effect. This workflow is non-destructive, so you can have a lot of control over your scene. I'll show you every step and some extra tips at the end. Let's begin by having a 3D object first. You can model something yourself, and you can get free models from the web, or from add-ons like Blender Kit. Objects can have textures and shaders on them, but you can also start without having any textures. First step of making your objects more painterly looking is to switch to rendered view, and adding a few lights so you can see what you are doing. Quick way of adding lights to one object is to use the Try Lightning add-on that you can enable at the preferences. Having your object selected, you can add three lights all at once that you can customize very fast. These lights enable you to quickly change the look of your scene later. Lights also automatically track to your object. Main ingredient to this workflow is the Kuvahra filter, which is a new feature in Blender 4.0. To use this workflow in real time, you must enable real-time compositing. I recommend using always-on mode, so you can see the effect without using a camera. Then drag a new workspace and change the space to compositor. Make sure you have use nodes enabled up here. Then press Shift-A, filter, and select the Kuvahra node. Place the node between render layers and the composite node. Default classic setting does an okay job depending on your scene, but when you change this setting to anisotropic, you have way more options and effects really starts to kick in when you tweak the values. If you want to disable the Kuvahra filter, select it and press M. To enable it, press M again. If you are using older versions, you can still follow the rest of the tutorial and get great results. Here's how you can quickly add outlines to your 3D object. This can speed up the painting workflow I'm going to talk about next. Be sure to be looking from the camera for this to work properly. Choose your object, press Shift-A, and add a crease pencil object line art. This adds outlines based on the 3D mesh automatically. You can tweak the stroke thickness and opacity right away to see how it looks. You can play with edge types to change how the lines are drawn. If you want to change the stroke color, head to the Materials panel and change it here. Now that we have a decent base to start, I can start talking about the actual painting workflow. You can paint 3D objects in so many ways. One of them is using the Sculpt Mode's vertex paint tools or texture painting. But these workflows are not super flexible when it comes to modifying and tweaking your painting. For that reason, we are going to use Crease Pencil for this workflow. Add a new Crease Pencil object to the scene with Shift-A shortcut. With the object selected, switch to Draw Mode up here. Change the stroke placement to surface. Tweak this offset value to a lower one and adjust this if you need to. Drawing plane should be set to view, and enable color attributes up here, so you can change the colors easier. You can also create a new material for fill colors at the materials panel if you plan on using them. Here's few shortcuts if you haven't used Crease Pencil before. F changes brush size. Shift F changes brush strength. Y changes layers. U changes materials. Right click or W summons the color wheel. When you hover your cursor on top of the color bar and press E, you can eyedrop a color. You can also create your own color palettes by pressing this plus symbol at the color menu. All these drawing tools and more can be added to quick favorites, which menu can bring up by pressing Q. For drawing, there are great settings that make things easier, like randomizing radius, strength, hue, saturation and values for instance. If you are using a tablet, these icons change if the value is affected by pen pressure. I recommend using layers for easier stroke management. You can also use masks to achieve more complex results. Crease Pencil also supports texture brushes. Here I am using brushes from my texture pack that has everything you need. Buying the pack is also a great way to support this channel. You can get great results fast, without messing too much with modifying the strokes and other options that I'm going to talk about next. If you want to make procedural changes to your paintings at any time, using modifiers is the right call. Let's say you would like to have the strokes stick to the 3D object more. You can try using the shrink wrap modifier. You choose the 3D object you are working on and tweak the snap mode, offset, and smooth values for better results. Let's also say you want to change the stroke thickness to be more interesting. Add a thickness modifier, check the custom curve on. Make changes to the curve and increase or lower the thickness factor. You can add another thickness modifier if you want to control the shape you just created more. Another thing I use a lot is the opacity modifier. When you change the mode to hardness, you can make strokes more softer at the edges. Also, using multiple strokes modifier can be great in certain situations, because you can tweak the distance and add fade to extra strokes that are created. Another great one is the noise modifier. You can play with different values like the noise scale and thickness to get an interesting look to your strokes. You can disable the randomize option so it doesn't change when you play the animation. I recommend to play with other modifiers as well, like smooth and subdivide. In the future, you should be able to make your own as well. All these modifiers also work with the line art object. Since grease pencil strokes are made of points, you can also sculpt these strokes manually using the sculpt mode. There's a variety of tools that go from smoothing to moving and adjusting stroke thickness, strength, and randomizing points. Holding control while sculpting reverses the effect. All these tools can be added to quick favorites. If you have a complex painting with many layers, you can use an auto-masking tool, so you can have more control over the parts you are tweaking. Now, a few tips about tweaking the painted colors. Grease pencil objects can react to lights, so you can try changing light objects in your scene for different look. And if your painted colors happen to look weird, you can try checking the Use Lights box under the Layers panel. If you need to change the color of your strokes, you can do so by using this tint brush in Draw mode. Another quick way to change the colors is to use a Hue and Saturation modifier. If you have multiple layers, you can also choose which layer to affect. You can also try different blend modes and changing the layer opacity for quick tweaking. Another fun way of tweaking the look of your painting is to use effects like shadow, where you can choose a complementing color, and adjust its alpha value if needed, and change the offset a little. Another cool one is the wave distortion effect, that helps to break the uniformity of the stroke. You can also use blur effect to soften the painting even more. Tweaking the samples can give you different results fast. Finally, here's 5 extra tips that you should know. Number 1. If your renders happen to look weird like this when you hit render, meaning the object doesn't block the other side that should be invisible, remember to enable Z-Pass at the Passes page. Also, if you have trouble painting on top of a 3D object, you can try setting object visibility to be at front. Number 2. Sometimes you don't need to have geometry visible in the final piece. You can have 3D objects in the scene that you paint over, and still hide them using these outliner symbols, so they don't show up in your final render. Number 3. Other sources. You can replace the original render layers with other nodes. For example, add an image node and render it using the Kuvara node, or add a movie clip to make any clip more stylized. Just remember to increase the frame count before you render. You can add a scale node and set it to fit the area if you like. This is fun to try with old projects to make them more stylized. Number 4. More compositing. You can try dropping new nodes to the composite workspace, like Sunbeams node for godlike effects, Glare node for some wonky ghosting, Posterize and Blur nodes for fake bloom effect. The list goes on forever. Number 5. To have the ultimate control over your painting, I recommend using View Layers. First, place the objects you want to render separate to their own collections, then add a new view layer up here. Disable stuff you don't need using these checkboxes. Then add the compositing. Duplicate render layers node with Shift D. Change the view layer for the second node. You can add these two nodes together using a mix node or alpha over node. Hopefully, these will be included in the real-time compositor soon, since it doesn't work right now. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching and see you next time.